So game one wasn't terribly interesting, but I thought game two was much, much more interesting. So here goes that. So this hand is obviously unkeepable on the draw or on the play. This one is fine, you know, pretty medium. First draw is Evolving Wilds, which we're obviously gonna play, and is gonna become a Plains. Seeker is a great draw, but there is some concern about the fact that you cast Seeker means it's a little harder to cast Rabble Master because you have to worry about Drown in Sorrow. But generally, I just jam. Drown in Sorrow is a card that people often don't even bring in against you, or don't bring in that high a number, especially better players, because they realize that the way your deck changes post sideboard means that it's going to be less good. So against a player like Sean, I would perhaps expect him to board in fewer of them. So I just jam the Rabble Master. He ends up Abzan Charming to draw two, which almost certainly means he does have Drown, because why else would he do that? You know, otherwise he'd be saving it to kill the Rabble Master or whatever. So he drowns away the board, which is obviously rough, but we draw an Ashcloud Phoenix, perfect draw. He plays a Temple of Silence. And we don't draw a land, but Chandra is not bad either. So attack with the Phoenix first, because if he's going to kill it or whatever, we'd rather have him do that now. And then hopefully our Chandra can live. So he downfalls the Phoenix, which is nice. Means he doesn't have another Abzan Charm. So then we're going to play Chandra. And we actually have a decision here between zeroing and trying to hit a land, because playing Sarkhan is so good. Especially if he plays Elspeth, we'd really want to have hit our land already. And we don't want to zero this, because if he plays an Elspeth, we need to hit it for five, right? So we need to hit with Sarkhan and the plus on Chandra, so he can't really afford to zero next turn. So yeah, but anyway, decide against that. I think this might have been a mistake, because the one damage is like not that likely to matter, whereas the extra land could really matter if he plays an Elspeth next turn. Fortunately for us, no Elspeths. Just plays a Courser and then kills Chandra. And we draw a Storm Breath, so as it turns out, zeroing would have been very bad anyway. We could choose to chain this Courser, but because there's a Siege Rhino coming and we can Sarkhan minus to kill the Courser, I decide not to play the chain. So he attacks with Courser and then obviously jams the Rhino, but now there's an Utter End in the mix. So chaining the Rhino is also starting to look a little bit awkward. Fortunately for us, we draw a land and go with Storm Breath over Sarkhan because we couldn't protect Sarkhan this turn. Whereas if in a later turn, you know, he taps out for something, like say an Elspeth, and we draw a land, we can cast Chain and Sarkhan in the same turn, and at least have it survive for one attack. So he casts Read the Bones, which I was pretty happy about at this point. Doesn't show. So he drew Nissa and Courser. I was very surprised Nissa was still in his deck. And the Courser is unlikely to matter too much. Especially if we can deal with the Rhino. So he plays the other Courser. And then rumbles for six. Puts us down to nine. Another chain is obviously a great draw because it means that we can sort of permanently deal with the Rhino. But decided to end up going with Sarkhan here, just to get the board under control, basically. And the plan is to block with Storm Breath, because at this point I don't think that he very likely has any answers. So my plan here was to block with Storm Breath, and I guess I decided to attack with it. I think maybe I should have blocked with it. But anyway, so I attack with Storm Breath, hoping that he's out of answers. He's gonna have to spend a turn attacking Sarkhan, and then next turn we can. Oh, that's right. This makes sense actually. I'm thinking that next turn he'll gain maybe one life, maybe not. I was hoping he wouldn't, because I knew he didn't hit a land off of that other one, and he didn't play a land last turn. So I was hoping that he would he'll spend resource. You know, he'll attack and kill Sarkhan, which is fine because we have another one, and we'll play it and aid him and just kill him immediately. But that doesn't quite work out. So he does indeed attack and kill Sarkhan, and attacks me with the Rhino, obviously. and then plays an Elspeth and kills his Rhino and our Dragon, which is actually really good for us because it means Ashcloud Phoenix can kill Elspeth, and another Stormbreath was obviously the perfect draw. Because now what we can do, we know about the Nissa in his hand, so he can't just play Stormbreath and smash, because then he'll play Nissa and we'll be dead to Nissa plus Courser attack if we attack Elspeth with the Ashcloud and him with the Stormbreath. And if we play Stormbreath to block, then Nissa puts us in a really bad spot because we will have to we'll have to block an elemental and the Stormbreath would die. So what we end up doing is we play Sarkhan, I believe, is what I ended up doing. Obviously thought about that decision a few times and changed what I was going to do. Play Sarkhan, kill Courser, kill Elspeth. So basically extend the length of the game. He plays Nissa pretty much as expected, pluses and takes down Sarkhan, which is fine because we have Chain to the Rocks, and now his Utter End doesn't really do anything good with Chain to the Rocks. We got a little lucky to draw this Stoke the Flames, but really an untapped land would have been the same thing. So we had quite a few outs to kill Nissa as well as his land, which is what we do, obviously, and hit him down to 7. He untaps, reads the bone again, going down to 5, which is hugely relevant, as you'll see in a moment. Because now we know he has Utter End, but we have Stormbreath. So he's going to Utter End the Ashcloud as expected. Go to 1. Then he has another Elspeth, which was a wrinkle I wasn't expecting. Destroys our Stormbreath, and we finish the job with the last one. So all in all, a very close game. Like I said, I think I made a mistake with that Chandra, plussing it rather than zeroing it. But, you know, it was an interesting game. So anyway, there you have it. Sorry about the missing round.